Welcome back, folks. Today, we're going to take a closer look at this browser because this thing is great. And it's basically a portal into your computer. And if you set it up properly, it's going to save you a ton of time. Okay? And I know it's a kind of a pitfall for a lot of people when they're first starting out is where to get everything quick, how to get access to your stuff fast. And we are going to set that up. Okay? All right, let's get started. Okay, so if you are new to Bitwig or if you've just installed it and you don't have any previous content like samples for snare drums, for example, or whatever, you're not going to have a whole lot of stuff. And Bitwig actually comes with a lot of great content that they give you for free when you get the program. So let's go check some of that stuff out. Go up here and click the dashboard icon. And you might be here, but just go over and hit packages. And just kind of scroll through these and install what you think you're going to like. You can click on them and read a bit about them. I just went and installed everything except for some of the teasers because I want the full deal. But you choose what you like and just bear in mind that some of them can be big. This one's only 93 megabytes. Some of them are a few gigs big. So just realize that it's going to take up a decent amount of space. And so just be choosy if you're worried about that. Okay. So once you do that, it's going to take a little time. So maybe just start downloading and installing a bunch of them and then go have dinner. Okay. Once you've done that, you'll notice in here, you'll have a ton of stuff. And it would be super chaotic if you weren't able to organize some of it, right? And that's what we're going to talk about right now. So starting from the left here, you have your devices, okay? And by devices, they mean all of your plugins, whether it is stuff that comes in Bitwig or just otherwise, okay? If you want to filter some of that stuff down, of course, you can click your favorites. And you can see I went into everything and I put a star. I clicked the star beside stuff that I know I'm going to use often. And that way, when I click favorites, it's all right there. If I no longer want it in my favorites, I simply uncheck the star. Okay? All right. So if you're in everything, you can filter down by the location of where it is on your computer. The type of device, is it an audio effect, an instrument, yada yada. The category, which I mean, this is a great one right here because sometimes I can't remember the name of a plugin that I want, and so I can just click category. Oh, it's a reverb. All right, click reverb, find it in there, or you can go by creator. Right there, okay. So you can kind of see what's the company that made it. Oh, it's Akon Digital. And there's my favorite plugin. Okay. All right. So you can actually create new, like almost like a new favorites. So let's create a new smart or a new collection. And we'll just call it lesson two. Okay. So now you'll notice that this little arrow is pointing towards the star on this. If I go here, set as target collection, now the arrow is there. But if I want to add stuff to this, I right click and set it as the target. That means if I go into everything, if I go into everything, whatever I put a star beside will show up in here. Okay? And that's basically the majority of how you're going to set up and organize your favorites. And you can create this in any of these categories, and that'll help you. If you want to collect all your favorite snare drum samples, all your favorite kick drum samples, you can do that and just label them appropriately, and that will speed up the time that you spend searching for your favorite stuff in half. Okay, I'm gonna put this back here. I'm gonna press delete and get rid of that because I don't need it. Okay, these are the presets for the devices in here. Okay. So this is going to be a big, big folder because everything inside here, every one of these plugins is going to have who knows how many presets. Like if you have like a reverb and you click the presets and the reverb, it's going to have ones for guitar, it's going to have halls and rooms and stuff like that, and that's all going to be in here. And this is an insane, look at the scroll thing right here, okay? And I'm flicking this quick, and it's like, it's ridiculous, okay? So this is another area where you might want to filter that down a little bit, depending on the criteria that you give it. As soon as you click a category, it'll show up there, and then you're kind of into it. If you want to go back to everything, exit it, okay? That little X. And the same goes for samples. Now, of course, you can search if I want a kick. There's anything with the name kick in it, okay? And now, I can press play like that, or I can just tell it by pressing this that as soon as I click one of these files, just start playing it. Okay, that was one of the Bitwig that came with Bitwig. So if I click this and turn it off, I can click things and it won't make a sound. If I turn it on, it automatically triggers that sample. Okay, and I generally turn this on right away because I'm never gonna really click on something. Like, why would I click on something and not want to hear it? I can scroll without clicking, so. Yeah, that's my only personal preference there. And this just sets the tempo to your song, okay? So if I have a different tempo here than what this clip it has natively been created at, it will adjust the clip to accommodate my tempo. And that's handy because if I'm writing a song at 110 and I want a drum loop and it's at 125, I don't want to hear it at 125. I want to hear it at 110. So now, if I click this, you see it's 110. If I turn this off, okay, all right. This is your volume. You can adjust the volume. I don't know why you would. It's kind of just, but it's really tiny too. I guess you can scale up your GUI scaling here and make it a little bit bigger, but that's like ridiculous. It's like 2 pixels. Let's just decrease that again. Okay. Now, the beautiful thing about this, oh, before I get into that, is this is the last one here. It's just files. It's just a pretty big umbrella term, just like what, every file? Basically anything that's pertinent to Bitwig. And one of my favorite things is recent projects. Okay, I can go into one of my recent projects and check it out. It's got everything in here that I created in that project, so I can go in and find the exact effects chain, even the sample that I want from that from this project called 80s version 2, and drag it in there, and now I have it in my new project. And that's pretty cool. But what's even cooler is if I've created, say, the perfect sub bass over here, okay, I can drag it into there, give it a name, and I'll find it in clips. So I created one here called Please Subscribe, okay? And you'll notice, as soon as I drag it out of there, it has the MIDI data that I made, it has the organ, it has the diatonic transposer, and everything in it. If I had just made this, I could grab this, drag it into there, and it says, give it a name, and that's what I did. I called it Please Subscribe, okay? And now when I type that, PLZ, into here, or Please Subscribe, it's right there. Okay, so say you made the perfect sub bass or the perfect drum kit or anything, or you're recording guitar and you have just the best chain of effects. You could set up everything you think you're ever going to use on a guitar chain, for example, and just create, just double click and it creates a region and drag that region into here. Okay. For whatever reason, if I try to drag this in, it doesn't want me to do it. It wants to know that you have something here. So even if you're just setting up like a template guitar thing. Let's do that right now. Okay, so say this is for a guitar. I know that I'm gonna want a compressor. Okay, and sorry, I should have said, I double clicked here, it brought me to the devices page, and I clicked plus, I added a compressor. Maybe I'll want a reverb. I'll throw in the reverb, and just whatever, like anything else that you might want to put in there, some chorus maybe, whatever you got. Okay, and say you even go in and you click this button, I'll show you that again, this little folder right here, right there, that's choosing a preset for the compressor. Okay, and look at that, guitar compression. If I wanted to, I could go into presets here and type guitar compression, but in this case it doesn't really make any sense when I can just click that and it brings me all the presets that are pertinent to this type of compressor. So I choose guitar compression, for example. Maybe my reverb, I choose amphitheater. And in the chorus, vibrato. Okay, so there we go. Now this is basically set up for my guitar. Okay, now if I double click there, it creates this fake region. See, if I double click this, there's nothing in that region. Obviously not, because I haven't recorded anything. But if I take this, drag it into there, and let's call it lesson 2 guitar. Okay, press OK. And now I type in lesson 2 guitar. All right, so I drag that out, double click here, and look at that, everything is still intact. Okay, and that's a beautiful thing, because oftentimes you could not end up changing your sub bass very much. Maybe just some of the effects that are on your sub bass, or maybe just some of the effects that are on your guitar. So what you could do, if you double click this, it shrinks it down, okay? What you could do is add anything here that you think you'll ever want on your guitar, and then turn them all off, and then drag this into there and call it guitar. And now when you go to record a guitar, instead of coming here, right clicking, add audio track, bringing in all those devices again, setting their presets, all that crap. As soon as you're inspired and you want to record some guitar, you just type in guitar, whip it into there, and then you'll have all your effects. And then because they're all off, you can say, oh, well, I definitely, this time I want some compression and I want some reverb. I don't want any chorus. Well, that's fine. Just leave it off. And there you go. You're recording guitar the way you want to do it. And you wasted no time setting it up either, because when it hits you, you want to record it and you don't want to wait, right? It's all about streamlining that process, about shortening that delay between when you hear a song in your head and actually getting it in here. And when you're a young musician, it's almost like your brain has a hard time holding on to a song for a very long time. So if you think of a song, you jump out of bed and you run over to your computer, you open it up, and then you got to surf through all this crap. What effect do I want? What, you know, what snare drum sample do I want to use? By the time you pick even just a snare drum sample, you're going to lose the song. And it kind of goes, it's kind of a double-edged sword too, because when you're a young musician, you don't have all this stuff organized yet. And so not only is it harder to hold on to a song in your head, it takes you longer to find it, and it kind of just double screws you. So that's why I'm recommending now, you just go ahead and set it up. Find your favorite of everything and put it into your favorites. And that way it's right there when you need it and you can load it up and away you go. Okay. As you develop as a songwriter, your brain almost works out and it's able to hold on to the song a little bit longer while you go and figure stuff out, to the point where you could just stay in bed, wake up the next morning, and then go make the song. Okay. So, all right, I think that's as far as we're going to go with the browser for now. There's still some stuff to learn, but I think a good starting point is to just go and create collections or just use your favorites. I've gone on fine just using my favorites, and go into everything here and just put a star beside the stuff you think you're going to use, And over time, you'll probably add stuff and remove stuff from your favorites depending on what you're actually using. But it's a good thing to set up now because when you like I said, when it hits you, and you gotta get it out, man. All right, okay. So once again, please subscribe. And if you have any comments or questions, leave them below, and I will be happy to get back to you as soon as I can. It's just if I get like a million questions overnight, it might be a little hard, but I will set aside some time every day to reply to you guys, okay? And as always, if you've created a track you think is great, put it down there. Let's have a listen. Put a link to your SoundCloud or whatever you got down there, and let's have a go, okay? All right, guys, take care.